Hello guys, today in CE for People in a Hurry, we're going to talk about why it's always preferable to use 16 bits instead of 8-bit dev images when we're talking about displacement. But first, we need to know what does bit depth means. If we oversimplify how image files work, no matter the format, PNG, JPEG, EXR, etc., they'll end up saving color pixels. For example, if we have this image, we are saving 12 by 16 pixels. If we have an 8-bit depth, we are saying that each of those pixels have values in the red, green, and blue channels that are saved by a binary number of 8 digits, allowing us to have a maximum of 256 possible combinations per channel, with a range from 0 to 255. On the other hand, if we are working with an image that has a 16-bit depth, we are using 16 bits per channel per pixel, therefore getting a grand total of 65,536 possible values per channel. As you have probably realized by now, this is a huge difference of color possibilities just by duplicating the number of bits. In practice, this lack of values in the 8-bit depth images is handled by merging main tones to the closest color step, and as a result, the image is kind of flattened, therefore the value jumps between color levels are larger. Since the displacement map doesn't contain color information, but rather high values, these average colors can become an issue. Let's check, for example, an 8-bit displacement map. As you can see, the larger the color steps, the more visible the flat areas are in the displacement. If we use 16 bits, the steps will be smaller, hence the flat areas are less visible. Most of the time, the value range of a 16-bit depth image is more than enough to make the flat areas unnoticeable. That is why a lot of people never bother to use images with 24 or 32-bit depth, since the benefits are not visible in their workflow and the storage increases exponentially. Well, that's all for now. Hope you like this chapter of CE for People in a Hurry.
Good luck!